Who doesn't love playing with Lego? You point them out so I can call them a liar to their face. Lego is one of the most iconic toys ever produced and it has been around for over 50 years. So without too much of an intro, because we all know what Lego is, I'm Tosh from Pop Nonsense and here are 8 things you didn't know about Lego. Number 1. The design hasn't changed in over 50 years. This is a lesson in foresight, ladies and gentlemen. If you take a brick from 1967, if you can find one that hasn't been lost under the couch at your gran's house or hasn't met its merry demise at the dump, and pop down to your local toy shop and remortgage your house to buy a set from 2017, both bricks will still lock together. It's a perfect example of, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. If you take 6 of the 8 studied bricks, there are 915,103,675 different ways to connect them. I can't process numbers the same way your average man does, but that is a lot. If I had 915,103,675 of anything, I'm guessing I would have absolutely no space to store them. What I find even more fascinating about this though, is who came up with the maths to support this claim, and who is ever going to sit down with a pen, a piece of paper, and 6 Lego bricks to disprove it? No one. Number 2. Someone has actually built a life-size Lego house. James May, the Top Gear man, built a fully operational house using 3.3 million Lego bricks. By fully operational, I mean it had a working toilet and shower. It was so impressive that Legoland offered to take the house and display it in their theme park. But as it turns out, Lego were actually quite peeved with James May because he didn't ask them for any help. As impressive as this feat is, I can't think of anything worse than a toilet seat made out of Lego. Number 3. Their original name was Automatic Binding Bricks. I'll just let that sink in. Could you imagine asking your mum for the Automatic Binding Brick Millennium Falcon? Or the Automatic Binding Brick Simpsons House? Doesn't quite roll off the tongue, but at least someone had the sense to shorten it to Lego, which of course comes from the Danish phrase Leggot. Chances are I pronounced that wrong, which means play well. Number 4. The White Stripes. The music video for Fell in Love with a Girl by The White Stripes was entirely made out of Lego bricks. It was directed by Michel Gondry and used no visual effects whatsoever. That means everything you see in the video was painstakingly made by hand. The White Stripes couldn't strike up a deal with Lego and had to buy all the pieces themselves, which would have cost a fortune. The White Stripes actually contacted Lego to ask if they could release a small Lego version of Jack and Meg as a giveaway for the single, but Lego refused, stating, "We don't market our products to people over the age of 12. The video went on to win 3 MTV Video Music Awards, and Lego had a wee think about the deal that they had kiboshed and asked if they could revisit it. Jack White said no, because Jack White is a legend. Any man that can make a guitar out of a Coke bottle and a block of wood, then cut the mustard with Jimmy Page in The Edge and his 6 million effects pedals, is a god amongst men. Bonus fact, the kid at the start of the video is Michel Gondry's son. Number 5. Were you lucky enough to wake up on Christmas morning, rush downstairs to find that Santa had left you the Ultimate Collector's Millennium Falcon? No, me either, because my mum and dad hate me. Originally, the set sold for £342.49, but if you still have it in decent condition, then it could be worth upwards of £2,500. In fact, on Amazon right now, you can buy one at the low, low price of £3,704.52 plus £9.95 postage and packaging. Why not get 2? One for you and one for the dog. The set consists of 5,197 pieces, but contrary to popular belief, it is not the biggest. That accolade goes to the Taj Mahal, which has a total of 5,922 pieces. Number 6. The plural of sheep is sheep. The plural of vinyl is vinyl. And the plural of Lego is Lego. Number 7. It hurts when you stand on it. That's a fact. And with 2 small children, I can tell you that the stories are not embellished. I've never understood why Kevin McAllister didn't just glue the front steps of his house so Harry and Marv had to take their shoes and socks off and just cover the house in Lego and be done with it. But why does it hurt? Well, lucky for you, some bold scientists spent your tax money figuring out why. Lego is made from ABS plastic, which gives the interlocking brick system its strength, resistance and shine. This makes a strong and durable toy that doesn't give way to pressure. When you stand on a piece, the force of your weight concentrates on the point of contact, resulting in pain. Our feet have over 200,000 sensory receptors, and because Lego is the strong little brick that it is, it doesn't give in to the pressure caused by your weight, therefore it hurts. Thanks, science. Number 8. Lego started its life off as a wooden toy manufacturer. They made toys like wooden ducks, spinning tops and stuff like that. After plastic took off, the people at Lego decided to purchase a plastic mould injector, and the salesman they bought it from turned up with some samples of what a British man called Hilary Fisher Page was doing. He was making plastic building blocks, a design which he had patented. Lego decided to make the same design. Take a look at the Kiddycraft block. That looks pretty familiar. Lego basically used the design without ever getting in contact with Page, and over the years made some changes. The birth of the modern Lego brick didn't actually happen until 1958 when Lego added in the hollow tubes underneath the brick to help hold them in place. Page's daughter has said that he had died before finding out what Lego had done. There's a bit of fact and fiction in this story. In Lego's defence, Page's patent was only valid in Britain, Switzerland and France, so there was no Scandinavian patent in place, and it was Lego who developed the design that we see today, and it functions a lot better than Page's original concept. However, Lego did purchase Kiddycraft in 1981 and have had some hard fought battles to protect their patents since, suing companies like Tyco Industries for copyright infringement, a case which Lego actually lost. They have won a few cases though. In 2002, Lego took a Chinese company called Coco Bricks to court. Coco were forced to cease production and issue a formal apology. And there we have it, 8 things you probably didn't know about Lego. And if you did know some of them, who cares? You watched it. If you liked this video, then make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this. Catch us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, and have a look at pop-nonsense.com for more trivia, quizzes, reviews and polls. Cheers, and we'll see you next time.